the second model, there are two types of problems on the element stiffness matrix. The very first method is called as elimination method, and the second type of problem is called as penalty approach method. First, I will solve the problems on elimination method handling boundary conditions. Based on the boundary condition, based on the nodal displacement, okay, we are eliminating row and column. With the help of first method, elimination method, I am going to solve first problem. The figure shows make a note, the first question on the elimination method. The figure shows a one-dimensional bar element subjected to an axial loading. Taking it as a single bar element, determine first one nodal displacement, second one is stress in each element, and third one is reaction at the support. See, the figure is given in this problem. See, it is a 1D bar element. It consists of two nodes. See, you have to follow the step by step procedure. I will explain the very first step for solving this elimination method. By elimination method, first finite element model. Okay, you have to discretize this, the given bar element. After discretization process, okay, you will get two nodes. In this problem, it consists of two nodes, node 1 and node 2. Each node having, at node 1, the boundary condition, it having one degree of freedom. Node 1 having 1 degree of freedom, Q1, and node 2 having nodal displacement. Each nodal displacement, node 1 is having one displacement, let Q1, and at node 2, the nodal displacement, I take it as Q2. Okay, look at here, in the figure, at node 2, the tensile force is acting. The magnitude of the tensile force is given, 10 kN, E equal to 200 GPa, and area of cross section is given, A is equal to 10 power 4 mm square, and the length of the bar is given, 1000 mm. See the figure, you can make a note, and the node 1 is fixed in this figure. Node 1 is fixed. Because of fixed, okay, the boundary condition, there is no displacement at node 1, but at node 2 there is a axial load is acting at node 2 of magnitude 10 kN. And the very first step for the elimination method is, first draw the finite element model, and discretization I already written here. It consists of two nodes, and each node having 2 degrees of freedom. Node 1 having 2 degrees of freedom, and node 2 have 2 degrees of freedom. And first make a note, the given data, E is equal to Young's modulus value is given, 200 GPa, convert that into MPa, and you will get 2 into 10 power 5. And area of the element, the area of the bar is given as 10 power 4 mm square, and the length of the element is given, L1 is 1000 mm, and load at node 2 is given, that is, you can say it as F2 equal to 10 kN. The very first, second step is after finite element model from the figure. Next step is find out element matrix or stiffness matrix for 1D bar element for it. In this figure, it consists of only one element, okay, and you have to find out only one stiffness matrix for a bar element. The stiffness matrix for the bar element is given by, this is the formula we already arrived, the expression for stiffness matrix for 1D bar element. In the second model, I already derived the same formula. With the help of that formula, take that element stiffness expression for element stiffness matrix for 1D bar element, that is KE equal to AE by LE 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 for element 1. Therefore K1 equal to, what is the area of cross section? Area of cross section is 10 power 4 into Young's modulus value is given, 2 into 10 power 5 divided by 1000, 1 minus 1 minus 1. And just simplify this equation, finally I will get answer K1 equal to 1 10 power 6 2 minus 2 minus 2 2. And next, third step is global stiffness matrix. since there is only one element, the global stiffness matrix is same as the element stiffness matrix, because in the finite element model, or look at here, this is a Bohr element, it consists of two nodes and one element. Because of that reason, I calculated only for first element the element stiffness matrix. Okay, and the global stiffness matrix is same as that of element stiffness matrix because it consists of only one element. In the future problems, you will get 2-3 element problem will be there, you can add it for find outing the global stiffness matrix. Because of that reason, global stiffness matrix is represented by matrix K is equal to K1, what we calculated already here in the second step, the same answer you can write here. And next, third step is global nodal displacement vector. The nodal displacement vector for the Bohr is given by nodal displacement for this 1D Bohr element. There are two nodal displacement at node 1 Q1, at node 2 Q2. Therefore, the nodal displacement vector for the Bohr is given by Q is equal to, it can be represented by global nodal displacement vector as Q is equal to, it is a column matrix Q1 and Q2, or we can write it as row matrix Q1 Q2 transpose. Next, but Q1 and Q2 we don't know, we have to calculate what is Q1 and Q2. And next, fourth step is global load vector. The load vector for the Bohr is given by F is equal to F1 and F2. This is the formula, standard formula you should remember. If it is consist of consist of two element, it will become F1, F2, F3, F4. Since the it is a 1D Bohr element, only it consists of only one element, it has two forces at node 1 and node 2. At node 1 as well as node 2. Therefore, F is equal to F1, F2, column matrix. Force at node 1 is 0 because it is a constraint. It is a fixed, node 1 is fixed. There is no possibility of the forces at node 1. That's why substitute F1 equal to 0. And F2 is, it is given at node 2. The force is acting at node 2 is 10 into 10 kilonewton. Okay, as it is, I written here. Next, fourth, equilibrium condition. The equilibrium condition for the Bohr element is, this is the standard equation for equilibrium condition of the Bohr, that is K into Q, elemental stiffness matrix stiffness matrix multiplied with global nodal displacement vector is equal to force global load vector, that is KQ is equal to F. You have to follow the same step for all the problems on elimination method. These are the steps you have to remember. And K is given, K is already calculated, substitute the K matrix, K that is stiffness matrix of element 1, and Q is already, it is there already, we have determined Q is equal to Q1 Q2, and F is 0 into 10 power 3. Next, after calculating equilibrium condition equation, and I will get answer like this. And next, fifth step is applying boundary condition. See, from the figure 4.1, the boundary condition are Q1 is equal to nodal displacement is always 0. Q1 is always 0 because node 1 is fixed. Okay, and using elimination method of handling boundary condition, eliminating corresponding row and column with respect to known boundary condition, let Q1 equal to 0. Therefore, substitute Q1 is 0 already. Okay, you have to eliminate the corresponding row and column with respect to known boundary condition. Therefore, substitute here Q2 value will 2 into 10 power 6, Q2 equal to 10 into 10 power 3 because Q1 is 0 is already easy. Q2 equal to 2 into 10 power 6 into Q2 is equal to 10 into 10 power 3, therefore Q2 equal to 0.005. and after calculating Q2 value, substitute in the nodal displacement vector, Q is equal to, I will get 0.005 mm answer. Next, stress in each element. The stress, next sixth step is stress in each element. The stress in 1D Bohr element is given, this is the standard formula, we know that already. Sigma is equal to EE by LE minus 1 1 Q1 QI plus QI plus 1. I is equal to E, E is the number of elements in the given figure, what in the finite element model I is the node number, and first find out for element 1 the stress induced in element 1, that is sigma is equal to E is Young's modulus value is given 2 into 10 power 5 divided by 1000 length of element minus 1 1, and Qi is 0, Q1 is 0, Q2 is already calculated. Q2 is 0, Q2 is 0.005 already calculated, and after simplification the answer is the stress induced in element 1 is 1 megapascal. And next 6th 7th step is reaction at support. See, the reaction forces at the support is, this is the standard formula, R is equal to matrix R is equal to KQ minus F. Okay, hence it consists of two nodes, there are two support reaction will be there always. It has two reaction forces at node 1 and node 2. K is 10 power 6, 2 minus 2, minus 2, 2, and Q is 0. Nodal displacement vector is already calculated 0, 0.005. Minus F vector is, F is 0, because it is a fixed, node 1 is fixed, there is no forces at node 1, but node 2, there is an axial tensile force is acting at magnitude 10 into 10 power 3. You can substitute here, and finally, and simplify this equation, and I will get R1 and R2 value. R1 is equal to minus 10 into 10 power 3, and R2 is 0 always, 0 value. This is the final answer. Reaction force. And the next problem is, second problem is on the elimination method, shows one dimensional bar element to an axial loading, taking it as a two bar element, determine first one nodal displacement, and second one stress in each element, and third one is reaction at support. And this problem can be solved by, and using elimination method, find out displacement, stress in each element, and reaction at the support always. Okay, you can add it, that question, by using elimination method, find the above three factors, nodal displacement, stress in each element, and reaction at support. You can add it in the question by elimination method. In the examination, they will mention in the question paper, by elimination method, find out nodal displacement, stress in each element, and reaction at support. Okay, the figure is given. See, it is a 1D bar element. 1D bar element, and it consists of two nodes, node 1 and node 2. And here, and for the very first step is area of cross section and Young's modulus value is given, and the tensile, the magnitude of the force at node 2 is given 10 kN, and the length of the bar is given 1000 mm. Okay, and first step is in the elimination method to solve the problem, you have to follow the same procedure. First, as that of previous problem what I solved, first finite element model, modeling of the given bar using two bar element each having two nodes, and location of nodes are as shown in the figure 4.2a. Look at here, at node 1, node 2, node 3, it consists of three nodes. Okay, here clearly it is mentioned it is a two bar element, because in the problem, actually in the figure, it is showing that, it shows that only it is a 1D bar element. Don't all of you properly just compulsory read the question 2-3 times and solve the problem, because it is a 2D bar element. Means first in the finite element modeling part, you have to discretize this bar into two elements, because it is a two bar element. Okay, it consists of two nodes and three nodes and two elements, node 1, node 2, and node 3. You can take it from 1, 2, 3 like this also, it is no problem. Because of, for my convenience, I taken from numbering 1, 2, 3 here. And at node 1, the nodal displacement, each node has 2 degrees of freedom, and at node 1 the nodal displacement is q1, at node 2 q2, and node 3 is q3. And the L1 and L2, the L1 is the length of the element 1, and you can call it as node 1 to 2 element 1, and node 2 to 3 is second element. Okay, and the distance from node 1 to node 2, let's take L1 is the length of an element, first element, and L2 is the length of the second element. Therefore L1 and L2 equal to 500 mm, because 1000 mm is given, After dividing this whole bar element into two elements of portion exactly, L1 and L2 value is 500 mm. And next, since loading is in opposite to the x direction, and importantly node numbering can be done along the x direction as shown in the figure, or opposite to the x direction also, 1 2 3 also, 1 2 3 also, because here, look at here, there is a displacement will be in the direction of applied force always, first opposite to x direction. F1 is equal to -10 kN, F1 equal to -10 kN, because look at here, that is loading is opposite to the x direction, and importantly node numbering can be done along the x direction as shown in, or opposite to the x direction, node numbering opposite to the x direction. Because of that reason I taken 1 2 3, but magnitude of the force is in this direction, because the displacement is in x direction it is given. Importantly, because of that reason F1 is -10 kN, opposite to that of x direction. The second step is calculate the stiffness matrix for bar element first. Okay, we know that already the stiffness matrix for bar element, we already know this formula, ke equal to ae by le, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Since in this problem it is clearly mentioned it is two bar element, it consists of two elements, you have to calculate separately for first element and second element what is the stiffness matrix for element 1 and element 2. First I am calculating what is the stiffness matrix for element 1. K1 equal to 10 power 4 into 2 into 10 power 5, Young's modulus value is given, and the length of element is 500, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, and simplify this equation. After simplification I will get answer 10 power 6 4 minus 4 4 4. And look at here, you give the node numbering because you give the node numbering as for element 1, Q1 and Q2, Q1 and Q2, okay, are the nodal displacement for first element, that's why taken as Q1, Q2, give the node numbering Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2, like this, row as well as the column, because of each node has one nodal displacement value, okay, because of that reason I am giving the numbering as Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2 for first element. And secondly I will calculate what is the stiffness matrix for element 2. Similarly, K2 equal to AE by LE, 1 minus 1 1 minus 1 1, 10 power 4 2 into 10 power 5 divided by 500, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 is equal to 10 power 6, and after simplification I will get 10 power 6 4 minus 4 minus 4 4. Okay, therefore give the node numbering, element 2 is, this is the element 2, it connects node 2 to node 3, the displacement, nodal displacement at node 2 is Q2 and nodal displacement at node 3 is Q3 I taken, therefore give the numbering as Q2 Q3 Q2 Q3. Okay, and next, after calculating the element stiffness matrix for both the elements, next third step is find out global stiffness matrix. Global stiffness matrix for the bar is given by, in the problem it is a 2D bar element, it consists of two elements, K is equal to add both the matrix, element stiffness matrix for bar, element 1 and element 2, you can add it both, therefore K is equal to 10 power 6. Okay, but since look at here, it consists of, in this figure it consists of three nodes. Okay, the global stiffness matrix, the rank of the matrix what we will get after adding both all the two element stiffness matrix, we will get 3 cross 3 matrix, because it consists of three nodal displacement values. Okay, write it as Q1 Q2 Q3, 10 power 6 as it is, because 10 power 6 is common in both K1 and K2 value. Okay, 10 power 6 and 3 cross 3 matrix, right, draw the 3 cross 3 matrix and give the naming nodal displacement as Q1 Q2 Q3 Q1 Q2 Q3. Okay, first, in the first matrix, okay, the element corresponding to first column second row is 4 is there, but in K2 the element corresponding to Q2, I want the element corresponding to q1 and q1. See, in the matrix 1, in the k1 matrix, the element corresponding to first column and first row is 4, but there is no element present in first row and first column. Okay, as it is, you can return here. Okay, and the second element is minus 4. The element corresponding to first row and second column, first row, second row, first column. Okay, but there is no element first. There is no element present in second row, first column. Okay, q1 is not there since minus 4 as it is I written here. But in case of next, the element corresponding to q3 and q1, there is, but in k1 there is no element is present. q3 is not there, q3 element is not there. There is no element present in third row, first column. Okay, but in second matrix also there is no element present. Element is present in third row, first column. Okay, because of that reason you can take it as 0. And similarly, next I want the element corresponding to first column second row. Okay, first row in k1, first row second column minus 4 is there. But here in the matrix 2, there is no element present corresponds to first column and second row. Okay, there is no q2 value is here. Q2 row, no element is present here. Look at here, that's why minus 4 as it is. There is a element present in first row, second column. Okay, and next I want the element corresponding to second row, second column. Q2 here in matrix 1, there is an element present in second column and second row. 4 is there, 4 plus in k2, in matrix 2 also there is an element present in second row, second column and second row. 4 is there, look at here, 4 is there. 4 plus 4, 8. I return directly after addition, I return directly 8. And the element corresponding to third row, second column, q3, second column. But in matrix 1, there is no element present in third row, second column. There is no element is there, 0 plus. But in matrix 2, there is element present in third row, second column. Third row, second column, minus 4 is there. I have taken as minus 4 here. And next, what is the element corresponding to q1 and q3? But in matrix 1, there is no element present in first row and third column, q3 column. There is no q3 value here in the matrix 1. But in K2 also there is no element present corresponding to Q1 and Q3. There is no Q1 element here. Q1 element, because of that reason I taken as 0. And next, I want the element corresponding to second row, third column. Here, second row, third column. Okay, there is no element present here, 0. But in matrix 2, there is a second row, second column, minus 4 is there, q3 as it is, minus 4 here. And next, I want the element correspond to column 3 as well as third column, third row, but there is no element present, q3 element here in matrix 1. But in matrix 2, there is an element present at third row, third column. There is element present, that is 4 will be there, as it is I taken as here. Next, find out global nodal displacement vector. The nodal displacement vector for the bar is given by q is equal to q1 q2 q3 transpose, same as that of what I already solved previous problem. And load vector, global vector, the load vector for the given given by, there are three forces are acting at each and every node, therefore F is equal to F1, F2, F3, column matrix. F1 is minus 10 into 10 power 3, F2 is 0 and F3 is 0, because F3 is fixed, F2 there is no force is given, you can take it as 0 directly. And next, fourth step is equilibrium condition. The equilibrium condition for the bar is given by KQ is equal to F, therefore K is 10 power 6 and K matrix, global stiffness matrix, you can as it is copy and copy here K, take K value as that what we already calculated. And Q vector, nodal displacement vector is Q1, Q2, Q3, and force vector is 10, minus 10 into 10 power 3, 0, 0. Next, fifth step is applying boundary condition. See, the boundary condition for this problem is, see, look at here in the figure, node 3 is fixed, okay, hence Q3 is 0, and at node 1 there is a magnitude of the force is acting, okay, and the boundary condition is differ here. Q3 is 0 directly because it is fixed, and using elimination method of handling boundary condition, eliminating corresponding row and column with respect to Q3. See here, Q3 is there. Eliminating this third row, third column, eliminate it. Just eliminate this, sorry, eliminate this third row, third column, like this. Eliminate it. After eliminating, I will get what are the remaining values, 4 minus 4 minus 4, 4 8 10 power 6 outside, and Q1 Q2, because third row you should eliminate depending upon the boundary condition what it is from the problem. First you have to take the boundary condition for the problem. If any node is fixed, you can eliminate that corresponding row and corresponding column, Q1 and Q2, and just eliminate third row, third column, and remaining term I will get 4 minus 4 minus 4 8 Q1 Q2 and minus 10 into 10 power 3, 0. Therefore, on simplification, we will get, simplify this equation. After simplification, I will get answer Q1 is equal to minus 0.005 mm, Q2 is minus 0.0025 mm. And next, nodal displacement vector is Q is equal to Q1 value is already calculated, Q2 is calculated, but Q3 is 0 already, you know that. Because Q3 is, it is a fixed, nu 3 is fixed, because of that reason Q3 is 0. Next, find out stress in each element. See, for we know that this equation sigma is equal to E by Le minus 1 1 Qi Qi plus 1. Okay, find out for first element what is the stress induced in first element using this formula, 2 into 10 power 5 500 minus 1 1, and Q1 is minus 0.005 and Q2 is minus 0.025. and after simplification, okay, the answer for the stress induced in element 1 is 1 newton per mm square. And next, for element 2, sigma 2 is equal to E by Le, E is given 2 into 10 power 4, 5 divided by 500 minus 1 1, and Q2 and Q3, Q2 is minus 0.0025 already calculated, and Q3 is 0. And after simplification, the answer for the stress induced in element 2 is 1 newton per mm square. And the last step is reaction at support. Okay, to find out the reaction forces at the support, the standard formula is R is equal to KQ minus F. R is, there are three support reaction, because at each node there is the force is acting at all the three nodes, there is a corresponding three reaction force will be there always. Therefore, K is already calculated, 10 power 6, 4 minus 4, 0, minus 4, 8, minus 4, 0, minus 4, 4. As it is, I taken K value, global stiffness matrix value, that is K value, and Q, that is nodal displacement vector, okay, and minus force vector, minus 10, 10 power 3, 0, 0. And therefore, and after simplifying this equation, okay, R1, R2, R3 value, I will get 0, 0, 10 into 10 power 3. You will get approximately 0.0023 something value you will get after simplifying this equation. and finally I will get zero value, equated to zero value always. Okay, this is the final answer for this problem. The next problem is on penalty approach method. The very first problem on the penalty approach method, make a note, solve for stresses in a members of structure given below in figure using penalty approach of handling boundary conditions. See, this is the figure is given in this problem. See, look at here, it consists of two bars. In this figure, it is actually a stepped bar, okay, and this stepped bar, both the ends of the stepped bar are fixed, okay. The first bar is made up of aluminium material and second bar is made up of steel material, okay. At bar 1, okay, the magnitude of the applied force on bar 1 is given, that is 4000 newton, and area of cross section of aluminium bar is given, 1600 mm square, and area of cross section for bar 2 is given, that is 800 mm square, and the Young's modulus for both the bars is given, for aluminium having Young's modulus 80 gigapascal, and the steel having 210 gigapascal, and the length of aluminium bar is given, that is 250 mm, that is L1, and L2 is given as steel bar is given 250 mm. And the very first step, same procedure as that of elimination method. See, in this first step is finite element model, you have to discretize this stepped bar into 1D bar element, okay. And after discretization process, I discretize this stepped bar into 1D bar element, and I will get two elements, and you can count it as first element 1 and element 2, okay. And it consists of 3 nodes, each node having 1 nodal displacement. At node 1, let Q1 be the nodal displacement at node 1, and Q2 be the nodal displacement at node 2, and Q3 be the nodal displacement at node 3, and apply the forces. See, because F1 be the force acting at node 1, F2 be the force acting at node 2, and F3 be the force acting at node 3. But there is a magnitude of the force is given at node 2 is applied at a magnitude of 4000 newtons. And follow the same procedure after finite element model. Next step is find out stiffness matrix for each element. See, first I will calculate the stiffness matrix for element 1, that is ke is equal to ae by le, 1 minus 1 minus 1, and k1 is equal to area of aluminium bar is given, that is 1600, substitute here, Young's modulus of aluminium material is given 80, gigapascal is given, convert that into megapascal, because all the units should be in mm, all the units are in mm, that's why convert it into megapascal, that is newton per mm square, 18 to 10 power 3 250, 1 minus 1 minus 1, and simplify this equation. After simplify the equation, I will get 10 power 5, 5.12 minus 5.12 minus 5.12, 5.2, and you can give the node numbering as, see, element 1 consists of 2 nodes, each node Q1 be the nodal displacement at node 1 and Q2 be the nodal displacement at node 2, okay, and you can give it as node 1, 2, 1, 2, okay, give the numbering as 1, 2, 1, 2, and next find out the stiffness matrix for element 2, same K2 is equal to using AE by LE, 1 minus 1 minus 1, we know that already this equation, substitute all the values, area of steel bar is given, that is 80, 80 into 10 power 3, 80, 800, sorry, it is by mistake, 800 into 2.1 into 10 power 4, make a correction here, it is actually not 800, actually it is given as A2, they are taken as 800, it is wrong, you can add it 0, one more 0 here, area of cross section is given 800. And Young's modulus for steel material is given 2.1 10 power 5 divided by 250. After simplification, I will get this answer 10 power 5 into matrix 6.72 minus 6.72, 6.72, 6.72. Okay, this is for the stiffness matrix for element 2, and give the numbering for this matrix. Okay, and element 2 consists of, it will connects node 2 to 3, hence you can give Q2, Q3 namings. Q2, Q3, Q2, Q3, like this. Okay, and next find out global stiffness matrix. So the global stiffness matrix for the stepped bar is given by K is equal to K1 plus K2. Okay, add K1 and K2 matrix first. Okay, see, this stepped bar consists of 3 nodes, hence we will get 3 cross 3 matrix, and you will get 3 cross 3 matrix. Okay, first take the element corresponding to first row, second column. First row, first column. In matrix K1, first column, first row element is 5.12. But here, there is no element present in K2. That is Q1, nodal displacement value Q1 is not there. Because of that reason, as it is, you can return as 5.12. And next, the find out element corresponding to second column, second row, first row. Second column, first row, Q2, Q1. Second column, first row, minus 5.12. But there is no element present in K2. There is no element present in Q2 and second column, first row. There is no Q1 element here. Look at here, minus 5.12. Only it is present in K1. And next, find out the element corresponding to third row, first column, Q3, Q1. See, look at here, there is no element present in third column, first row. There is no third column here. In K2 also, there is no element present in third column and first row. Because of that reason, you can take it directly zero. Next, find out the element correspond to first column, second row. First, but in the matrix K1, first row, second column, minus 5.12. But in case of element 2, there is no element present second row, first column. First column, second row, Q1 is not there here, then minus 5.12. Next, what is the element corresponding to second column, second row, Q2, Q2. Here, look at here, in the matrix K1, second column, second row is 5.12, but there is also element present in element 2 also. Look at here, the element corresponding to second column and second row, second Q2 here. Look at here, in that particular Q2, 6.72, 6.72 plus 5.12, total I will get 11.84. and what is the element corresponding to third row second column, minus 6.72. but in K1, there is no element present in second row, third row, second column, so third column, second row, that's why minus 6.72. and there is no element present in matrix 1 K1, that is first column, third row. There is no element present in third row, first column, and zero directly can take. And what is the element corresponding to second row, third column, second column, third row, Q2, Q3. There is no element present Q2, Q3, minus 6.72. Okay, only it is present the element corresponding to second column, third row. That is 6.72. Minus 6.72. And lastly, the element corresponding to third row, third column. In matrix 1, there is no element present in third row, third column. But there is an element present corresponding to third row, third column is 6.72. Finally, I will get global stiffness matrix like this. And next, global nodal displacement vector is given by q is equal to q1, q2, q3 transpose, and global node vector is f1, f2, f3, 0, 4000, 0. And the equilibrium condition for the stepped bar is given by kq is equal to f. Therefore, k matrix, take what we calculated, and f matrix and q matrix as well as f matrix. And next, fourth step is applying boundary condition. The boundary condition are q1 and q3 is fixed ends. Node 1 and node 3 is fixed. Because of that reason, q1 and q3, that is nodal displacement is 0. Using penalty method handling boundary condition, therefore, in the penalty approach method, this formula you should remember, c is equal to maximum of kij into 10 power 4. This formula you should we should remember. That is very important. This formula we need to, we should remember this formula. Okay, here to take the maximum value of the element in the global stiffness matrix. In the global stiffness matrix, what we already calculated. See, in this matrix, okay, you have to take C as the maximum value in the 3 cross 3 matrix. See, find out which value is maximum in this 3 cross 3 matrix. That C value is this value, 11.84 is the maximum value, highest value from in the global stiffness matrix is, that is 11.84 into 10 power 5 is there. Look at here, 11.84, 10 power 5, common is there. See, the C value is nothing but in the elimination method, you have to take this formula to find out maximum Kij. The maximum of Kij is nothing but the highest value, that is maximum value in the 3 cross 3 global stiffness matrix. See, in this matrix, global stiffness matrix, the value of C is the value in which 11.84 is the maximum value in the global stiffness matrix. That's why taken as C value is 11.84, 10 power 5 into 10 power 4. Therefore, C value is 11.84, 10 power 9. This value of C is to be added to K11 and K33, where nodes are fixed. Therefore, global stiffness matrix. See, you need to say after calculating C value from the global stiffness matrix, okay, and add to the K11 and K33 where the nodes are fixed. Wherever the nodes are fixed. See, in this problem, node 1 and node 3, look at here, node 1 and node 3 is fixed. See, because of that reason, you need to add the value of C to K11 and K, this K11 and K33, this add it to diagonal element other than this middle element, diagonal element, add it to here, 5.12 plus 11.84 into 10 power 5, 6.72 plus 11.84 into 10 power 5, add it to both the elements and add it K11, C to be added to the K11 and K33 where the nodes are fixed. Okay, you can add it. After adding, I will get 11,84, 5.12 minus remaining term value should be same. You have to add only diagonal elements like K11 and K33. This is K11 and this is K33 element. Okay, in the from the global stiffness matrix, you can add it to 5.12 plus 11.84 into 10 power 4 plus 6 and you can add it to this K33 value, 6.72 plus 11.84 into 10 power 4. After adding, I will get this answer. After adding. And next, global force vector. Okay, in the global force vector also same thing, you can add it to f plus f1 plus ca1, f2, f3 plus ca3, and it will become f1 dash, f2 dash, f3 dash. Global force vector, you can add it to ca1 element, c into, this is the standard formula we should remember, and where a1 and a3 are the spring displacement is equal to q1 and q3 respectively, but q1 and q3 is 0 here, look at here, therefore f is equal to f dash is 0 and f3 also 0. It is similarly as that of the global force vector, but the thing is, if any displacement is not there, if displacement is fixed, you can take it as directly 0 and I will get f force vector is 0, 4000. And equilibrium condition equation can be written as kq is equal to f, and after simplifying this kq is equal to f equation, I will get 3 answer, q1, q2, q3. That is the nodal displacement values at node 1, node 3, node 3, node 2, node 3. Okay, and therefore Q, I will write it as 1.40 through this the same and answer what we are got after equilibrium in the KQ is equal to F equation. After simplifying the whole equation, I will get three answer. Q1 is equal to 1.46 into 10 power minus 7 mm. Q2 is 3.37 10 power minus 3. Q3 is 1.917 into 10 power minus 7. Okay, you can write down in the matrix form. Q is equal to Q1, Q2, Q3 transpose, because always the nodal displacement vector should be in column matrix, but I written in the transpose matrix also, it is no problem. For your convenience, you can write, but it should be always in column matrix. And the next sixth step is stress in each element. We know that already the stress in bar element is given by E by LE minus 1, 1, QI, QI plus 1. See, first calculate what is the stress induced in element 1 using this formula. And substitute the values and simplify the equation, and I will get the answer. The answer for the stress induced in element is 1.081 megapascal, and for element 2, sigma 2 is equal to 2.8348. After simplifying, and next find out reaction forces. See for elimination method, sorry, penalty approach method, the to find out the reaction forces at the supports for R1 and R3, there is only reaction force at R1 and R3. Because R2 there is force is acting, there is no reaction force, but reaction forces should be always wherever the fixed end is there. Okay, support reaction we should calculate only wherever the supports will be there. Okay, the node 1 and node 3 is fixed, only the reaction forces you should calculate at node 1 and node 3. The reaction forces at node 1 is minus C into Q1. This is the standard formula we should remember, and find out first R1 is equal to minus C into Q1. Minus C is, already we know that the maximum of Kij, that is what we already calculated. C value is 11.84 10 power 9 plus into Q1. Q1 is the nodal displacement. Q1 is already calculated, that is 1.46 10 power minus 7. You can multiply it. The answer after simplification I will get minus 1729.74 newtons. Similarly, R3 find out, that is for to find out the reaction force. Minus C into Q3, substitute the value of C and Q3, and finally after simplification I will get -2270.26. This is the final answer for reaction forces. See, remember in the penalty approach method, it is similar to that of elimination method, but the thing is, after obtaining the global stiffness matrix, we should add maximum of C, maximum value of Kij element from the global stiffness matrix, choose the highest value from the global stiffness matrix what we will calculate, and add it to the remaining fixed diagonal node element, means in the corresponding node diagonal element we need to add it. That is a very important thing. Next problem, a bar is having uniform cross-sectional area of 300 mm square and is subjected to a load of magnitude P is equal to 6000 kN as shown in the figure. Determine the displacement field, stress and support reaction in the bar. Consider two element and use elimination method to handle boundary condition. Take E is equal to 200 GPa. See, this is the figure is given. See, in this problem, the figure is given. Okay, this problem is very important. Maybe we will get for 10 marks in the examination. So many times it was asked in the previous year question paper, and try to practice the same problem. See, this is the 1D bar element. This is, we call it as gap problem. Okay, and there is a possibility of displacement value is given here. Look, 0.12 mm displacement value is given here. Okay, due to the application of the load here, the wall is there. That wall, it will just restraining the applied force, and it will just, it won't deviating behind this point. Okay, the displacement, because of the applied load, there is a possibility of displacement only up to this point. It won't go behind this point. Okay, the displacement of this axial bar I taken as let x, it is given, and this is bar, it consists of our first step is Young's modulus and area of cross section is given in this problem. Make a note the data. First step is make a note of the data. What are the data is given? L1 and L2 is given. Area of cross section is given. E value is given, and P value 600 kN is given. The very first step is you have to solve this problem by elimination method. the first step is finite element model. Model this bar considering two bar element. You have to discretize this bar. After discretization process, okay, it consists of two elements, element 1 and element 2. It consists of three nodes, 1, 2, 3. And for element, L1 is the length of element 1 and L2 is the length of the element 2. And Q1 be the nodal displacement, let Q1 be the nodal displacement at node 1, Q2 be the nodal displacement at node 2, and Q3 be the nodal displacement at node 3, and F1 be the force acting at node 1, and F2 is the force acting at node 2, and F3 is the force acting at node 3. See, this is the first step, that is finite element modeling. First you have to discretize the given problem. And next, second step is to find out the element stiffness matrix. Since it consists of two elements, find out the stiffness matrix for each element. First, find out the element stiffness matrix for first element. We know that KE is equal to AE by LE, 1 minus 1 minus 1. First, find out K value. Substitute all the values. Area is given, E is given, length of the element is given. And substitute all the values. After simplification, I will get K1 is equal to 10 power 5. 4 minus 4 minus 4 4, and you can name it as rows and column as, because element 1 it will connect node 1 and to node 2, you can give the numbering as 1 2 1 2. And next, similarly find out the stiffness matrix for element 2. Substitute the values of A, E and L value here. Area of cross section is given 300, Young's modulus for element 2 is given 2 into 10 power 5 and divided by 50, 1 minus 1. After simplification, I will get 10 power 5, 4 minus 4 minus 4 4. Okay, and element 2 is, it will connect node 2 and node 3, hence you can give it a name it as Q2 and Q3, Q2 Q3. Next, find out, third step is global stiffness matrix. To find out the global stiffness matrix, you can add both KI1 and K2, that is the stiffness matrix for first element plus stiffness matrix for second element. You can add both the stiffness matrix K1 and K2. After addition, I will get this simplification. After adding, I will get same. You will get 3 cross 3 cross. After adding K1 and K2, we will get 3 cross 3 matrix Q1, Q2, Q3. Q1, Q2, Q3. Same. For addition, we know that already. We already explained. Same procedure you can follow for addition of the matrix. And next, global nodal displacement vector Q is equal to Q1, Q2, Q3. We don't know, you have to calculate. Next, global node vector. From the figure, we see that gap between node 3 and support at the right end. Therefore, the force at node 3 cannot be equal to 0. Thus, the load vector can be written as, because there is a possibility of, there is no force at node 3, but there is a displacement will be there. Displacement value is there. Okay, because of that reason, okay, this is the gap problem, that is very important. The gap between node 3 and support at the right end, okay, and the force at node 3 cannot equal to 0. We should not take it, normally assume it as 0, because there is a possibility of displacement is there. There is a effect of force will be there also at node 2 here, because of the load is acting of magnitude at node 2 of magnitude 600 kilonewton. Because of this effect, there is a possibility of force also acting at node 3. See, in order to find out that force acting at node 3, but displacement is given. See, because of that reason, what I am going to do, see, I will calculate what is the force acting at node 3, and thus the force vector, it will become F1 K13 A3. Standard formula we should remember: F2 minus K23 into A3, F3 K33 into A3, where A3 is the maximum displacement at node 3, is A3 is given 0.12 mm. And next, fourth step is equilibrium condition, that is KQ is equal to F. K is, substitute the matrix K, global stiffness matrix. Matrix Q is Q1, Q2, Q3, and force vector is, you can take F1 minus K13 A3, F2 K23 A3, F3 K33 A3. This standard formula we should remember. If any gap problem is given in the examination, we should use this formula. See, first maximum displacement is given, that displacement value you should take it as A3 value. Okay, you need to subtract that A3 value with the corresponding row and column value of the corresponding row and column value. Okay, multiplied with that value, with all the force values, F1, F2, F3 value. Standard formula we should remember. Okay, and apply the boundary condition. Since the figure, from the figure, boundary conditions are Q1 is equal to 0 and Q3 is 0.12 mm. Node 3 can have a maximum displacement of 0.12 mm. Using elimination method of handling boundary condition, eliminating corresponding row and column with respect to known boundary condition. Corresponding, okay, we have to eliminate corresponding Q1. We need to eliminate using boundary eliminating corresponding row and column with respect to known boundary condition, that is Q1 and Q3. We need to eliminate Q1 and Q3. Eliminate first row, first column, third row, third column, and finally the remaining term I will get 8 × 10⁵. Q2 is equal to F2 into K minus K minus K23 into A3. Okay, after simplification, I will get K2 value as 0.81 mm. Therefore, nodal displacement vector is given by Q is equal to Q1 is 0, Q2 is 0.81, what we already calculated, Q3 is 0.12, because there is a displacement is there, Q3, that is 0.12 mm. And next, find out stress in each element. We know that sigma is equal to E by LE minus 1, 1, QI, QI plus 1. To find out first stress in element 1, that is substitute all the values E by L value and Q1 and Q2 value here, and the answer after simplification, the answer for the stress in element 1 is 1084 megapascal. And next, stress in element 2, sigma 2 is equal to 200 × 10�³ minus 11 0.812. Simplify this equation, the answer for the stress induced in element 2 is minus 920 megapascal. This is the final answer. And next, seventh step is support reaction. R is equal to KQ minus F, R1, R2, R3. Because it consists of two elements, there are three reaction forces. And K value, global stiffness matrix already calculated. And just K value take from determined value, the matrix multiplied with matrix Q and F. And just simplify this equation, finally I will get R1, R2, R3 is equal to R1 is equal to minus 324 into 10 power 3, 0, and R3 is minus 276 into 10 power 3. Okay, this is the final answer. After simplifying this KQ minus F equation, finally I will get answer is, this is the final answer. Okay.